the today's lecture, I will continue the numericals on EMFication of an alternator. So, take the next question. The question is, a 2-pole, 3-phase, star-connected alternator has armature of 42 slots and 2 conductors per slot. It revolves at 3000 rpm. Calculate the flux per pole required to generate the line voltage of 2300 volt. So, assume pitch factor is equal to 0.956 and distribution factor is equal to 0.952. So already we have solved two problems on the EMF equation. The only difference is, in the previous problem we need to calculate the line voltage, but in this question the line voltage is already given, so we need to calculate the flux per pole. So first I will write down the given data. So a 2 pole, so P is equal to 2 and 3 phase star connected, so the number of phases is 3, star connected armature having 42 slots, so the number of slots is 42, 2 conductors per slot, in each slot 2 conductors are inserted, conductors per slot is 2. And it revolves at 3000 rpm, means the speed of an alternator is 3000 revolutions per minute. Calculate the flux per pole, that is pi we have to calculate, and the line voltage is given, that is EL, line voltage means EL, which is equal to 2300 volts. Assume pitch factor AP is given 0.956 and distribution factor KD is 0.952. So I written all the given data given in the question. So now the first step is, so if you want to calculate the flux, so the equation is EPH is equal to 4.44 F into pi into TPH into KP into KD. So this is our equation, main equation. So see, 4.44 is constant, frequency is not given, so we need to calculate the frequency. Okay, this parameter is not given, and pi, flux per pole, we need to calculate. TPH also we don't know, KP and QD are already given in the question. So three parameters we need to calculate to get the value of EPH. And EPH means what? Which is equal to, for star connected, EL by root 3, EL is also given. So first I will calculate the frequency. To calculate the frequency, so we know that F is equal to N into P by 120 to calculate the frequency. So N is equal to how much? It is given 3000 rpm into P, number of poles is 2, pole divided by 120, so we will get 50 hertz. So by using this relation you can calculate the frequency of an alternator, that is 50 hertz. That is the first parameter. Next I will go to the TPH. So already I said, to calculate the TPH, so first we need to calculate the Z. Z is equal to what? It is the total number of conductors. The formula is total number of slots into conductors per slot. So this is the formula to calculate the total number of conductors, Z. So total number of slots is how much? Number of slots is 42, conductors per slot is 2. So just to do multiplication of 42 into 2. So we will get 84, that is the value of Z, total number of conductors in the armature. And so we know that we need to calculate the conductors per phase. How many phases are there? It is a 3 phase alternator, so that is why the number of phases will be 3. So ZP is equal to what? Z by 3. So 84 by 3, you will get 28. And to get the value of TPH, so TPH formula is ZPH by 2. So 28 by 2, you will get 14. Simple. The procedure to calculate TPH is, first calculate the Z, total slots into conductors per slot, you will get the 84. ZPH per phase means number of phases is 3, so divided by 3, you will get 28. And 28 by 2, you will get the total number of turns per phase. So this parameter also we calculated. Then we can go to the last step, that is the total flux per pole. So 2300 by root 3 in the electric side is equal to 4.44 into, and substitute all the values directly, f is 50 hertz, we have done the calculation, into pi we need to calculate, so I will keep it as it is, so into pi as it is, into TPH means 14, we got the answer 14, into Kp into Kd, Kp is 0.956, into Kd is 0.952, and in the LHS side, I substituted the 2300 by root 3, because EPH is the equation, but it is given line voltage. Line voltage means EL. For star connected system, we know the relation EPH is equal to EL by root 3. So this is the formula for star connected system. That's why. So EPH is the formula. Here I substituted the EL by root 3. EL means 2300 divided by root 3 is equal to, as per the formula, 4.44 F pi as it is EPH Kp into Kd. That's it. So now just the next option, next is we need to separate the value of pi, that is the flux per pole. So if you separate the value of pi from this equation, you will get pi is equal to 0.469 Weber. That's it. Just to substitute all the values and separate the pi, so 2300 by root 3 will get one value, whole divided by 4.44 into 50 into 14 into 0.956 into 952, we will get the answer is 0.469 Weber. So this is the calculation of flux per pole. So we will take the next problem. So question is, a 3 phase 50 hertz 16 pole alternator with star connected winding has 144 slots and 10 conductors per slot. It revolves at 375 rpm. Calculate flux per pole required to generate a line voltage of 2657 volts. Assume pitch factor is equal to 1 and distribution factor is equal to 1. This is the similar example what we are discussing now. Only thing is the data is given different. That's it. Okay. The data, the given data, that is 3 phase means the number of phases is 3. And frequency is given 50 hertz. And the 16 pole means P is equal to 16 and 144 slots. Total number of slots is 144 and 10 conductors per slot. Conductors per slot is 10 and it revolves at 375 rpm means NS is equal to 375 rpm. Calculate flux per pole means same. We need to calculate the flux with the help of this data, EL is equal to 2657 volts. So assume Kp is equal to 1 and Kd is equal to 1, which is again given in the question. So same procedure. So we will calculate the Z first. Z is equal to total number of slots into conductors per slot. So this is the equation to calculate the Z. Total number of slots is how much? 144 into conductors per slot is 10. So we get 1440. This is the value of total conductors in the armature. But we require ZPH, that is per phase. So per phase means Z by 3. Why it is divided by 3? Because the number of phases is 3. There is a 3 phase. So 1440 by 3. So you will get Z phase is equal to 480. Okay. And to get the value of TPH, turns per phase, so that is the equation is ZPH by 2. So 480 by 2. So you will get 240. So this is the procedure to calculate the TPH, Z, ZPH and TPH. So next I will go to the main equation. The equation is EPH is equal to 4.44 F pi TPH Kp and Kd. This is the EMF equation of an alternator. So EPH means what? That is EL by root 3, because it is a star connected alternator. So EL by root 3, 4.44 as it is. Into F, it is already given 50 watts. Into 50, flux per pole, pi we need to calculate. So keep as it is. Into TPH means 240. Into KP into KD. So it is given 1 and 1. So 1 into 1. So now is EL by root 3. EL is how much? So that is given 2657 by root 3. So 2657 by root 3 is equal to the same 4.44 into 50 into pi into 240. Okay. So only thing is just separate the value of pi from this equation. So I will write the direct value. So if you separate the pi value, you will get 0.028 Weber. So this is the value of pi. So I hope you understood this type of problems. So in this type of problems is, so we are going to calculate the flux. Already the line voltage is given. Okay.